Hey guys, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. Finally, we are here. Congratulations. We are finally in the last video of the ESP32 client part. In this video, we will talk about displaying icons that indicate the current status on the screen. This makes it easy to see what status the system is in and provides important information to the user. We only display two types of the information now, but it would be good to display other desired information such as time or current external weather temperature on the upper right of the screen. Then let's get started right away. First, this is the UI of the project screen that was created at the beginning of the project. Firebase off icon and Wi-Fi off icon are located on the right side of the screen. When the Firebase is ready to use, it's changed to the Firebase on icon. Wi-Fi also changed to the Wi-Fi on icon when it's connected normally. These image files are prepared in advance. It's included in the project folder so you can use them. I will put these icon files in SPIFFS and use them. In order to do that, we must first put these icons into ESP32 file system. Create a folder called data in the project root folder you are currently working on and copy all these icons within it. The easiest way to put the file into the file system of ESP32 is to use ESP32 sketch data upload. Let's go back to Arduino IDE and install files with it. Oh no, I cannot see the tool in the menu. This new Arduino IDE 2 is based on the Eclipse CI frameworks. That's why we cannot use Java-based third-party plugins. This is possible in the previous version of the Arduino IDE, so I will just take care of this part here. Open the project you are currently working on the first. You can run ESP32 sketch data upload right away because you have already put the necessary icons in the data folder. If you can't find it on the menu, please refer to the part about SPIFFS in the first video of my TTG series. It'll be helpful. It's done. You can see that the files have been properly copied to the ESP32 file system. We have nothing to do here anymore. Let's go back to Arduino IDE 2. I will add the additional code to the display class. An image decoder is required to output an image. I will use the TJPEG decoder that I already used in my project. With this, you can easily draw JPEG on the TFT LCD. First, add the header file. Since we want to output the size of the JPEG as it is, so set the scale to 1. The swap byte order is to avoid endianness inconsistency. For your information, Motorola's microprocessors use big endian order storage, while Intel's microprocessors use reader endian order. The bytes in the JPEG file are arranged in big endian order. Finally, we must register the output callback function that it draws on the screen. I will make a callback function. The necessary type arguments have already been predefined. It needs to use the same format. Because this callback function is not a member function, a point object that points to itself is required to access the member variables and functions. Create an instance for this class so that we have it. This callback function allows the image to be drawn to the screen. I will create a function for each icon so that the image can appear on the screen by calling the function. These functions will be called through the display object on the main. What we need to do now is to use SPIFFS so that we can read the files that we saved in the file system earlier. You may want to create a separate class for the file, but this project used the icons only from the file system, so it simply handles in this class. After the TFT is finished initializing, begin SPIFFS to prepare it for use. Let's go back to the show Wi-Fi icon function and complete. Because there may be a previous image before the icon is displayed on the screen, first paint the size of the icon black, the background color, then use the TJPEG decoder to draw the icon file on the screen. The position of the icon is the width of the screen minus the width of the icon. It makes the Wi-Fi icon to be located on the rightmost side. If isOn is true, draw icon Wi-Fi on JPG and force draw icon Wi-Fi off the JPG. The Firebase icon is also the same. The position of the rightmost minus 60, which is the width of the two icons. I will build it and see if there is an error. Yeah, there is no problem. Let's move on. Let's go to the main and update the init display function. Since the initial state of the system is all off, let's try to show the disconnected icons. Let's build and check the TTJO screen. The disconnected icons appear on the screen. It's very good. Now what we need to do is update icons according to the status of the network and Firebase. This time, we will try to modify the network class. This is a network class we have worked on so far. Let's make the enumeration type to create a type that represents each state. There are a total of 4 states here. The network is connected or disconnected, Firebase is ready or not. I will mark only connected and disconnected to make it easy. Let's create a format called function pointer integer and define it as being able to pass network state over argument. Using this type, let me define a function pointer called callback event. Let's create an overloaded constructor for the network. This constructor must pass the function pointer to the parameter. The f that comes in here becomes a callback event and can be called from anywhere in this class. When you get the local IP, you can say that it's ready to use the Wi-Fi. Call the callback event using instance and set network connected to the parameter. On the other hand, if the Wi-Fi is disconnected, hand over network disconnected to the callback event. For Firebase, you can see the status of the Firebase from the token status. If the status is ready, pass Firebase connected to the callback event. Otherwise, it will be Firebase disconnected. Let's go back to main and define a function to receive the event. Create a function called network event, and the parameter is network state that you have already defined in the network class. Because it's an enum type, you can handle it easily with the switch case. So you can turn on and off the icons for each state. In the init network function, it requires the creation of the object with a new constructor. Create a function pointer that references the network event function and passes it over to the network constructor. This will invoke the overloaded constructor that you just created and everything will work. Let's run it and check the results. It has the Wi-Fi on icon immediately because Wi-Fi connects quickly. As a Firebase token status becomes ready, the Firebase icon also changed to the on icon. Yeah, it's working seamlessly. Finally, we are able to complete all the parts of this project. Thank you for your efforts. That's the basic solution for Firebase projects. In this project, we tried to make it more C++ style by implementing classes separately for each role. We have covered the project configuration in more detail. So I hope it helps you. That's all for today's video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next project.